In today's video, we're going to go into Reach View 3 and activate the mobile data. That's necessary to allow the SIM card in the receiver to be able to support the receiver to consume NTRIP corrections from the internet. So to do that, we're going to ensure that our controller is connected to the correct Wi-Fi network, and then we will go into Reach View 3 and we'll show you some of the settings and requirements in there to activate your mobile data. Come on in and have a closer look. So we've got our Wi-Fi connected to the Reach receiver. So we now can go into Reach View, and once again, we can see our receiver listed. It's going to connect to the receiver and we can go into settings. You can see there's a mobile data page, which is currently turned off. So we're going to load the mobile data page. Prior to activating the mobile data, we do need to put in an APN reference. We're using a Telstra SIM card, so the reference is telstra.iph. If you have a look in the comments below this video, we'll add information for the APN reference for Optus. With regards to the authentication type, we don't need to worry about it for ourselves, but if you have a corporate SIM card and from an enterprise like a university or a major government or perhaps a multinational business, you may need to engage with the authentication. As a small business, it's not something that we need to do due to the way that our mobile data subscriptions are managed. So I can simply hit apply to apply that APN, and then I can come up and activate the mobile data. It's funny because it's a slider switch and it makes you think you need to slide it. But as with all the Reach View switches, you don't actually need to slide it. You just need to touch it. And it's going to go through. It's still showing mobile data off, but in the background, it's communicating with the tower and it's seeking to establish that connection. And you can see now the message has changed. It no longer says mobile data off. It shows connected to the network. So we know that our receiver is now consuming data from the internet, and if we were to go into a survey page and take a look at a project with a map in it, you can see that the map backdrop will actually start to populate with tiles from the online server that provides mapping backdrops, so long as this knows where it is. You won't see that if you're working in offline mode. So in today's video, we've shown you the process of using the SIM card that's already in your device to enable your Reach RS2 receiver to consume mobile data. That's the first important step in connecting to an NTRIP server to get corrections over the internet. The next step will be in another video where we show you the process of specifying the IP address and the necessary credentials, ports, mount points that are all required to allow your receiver to connect successfully to an NTRIP server on the internet and to provide corrections back to your receiver. Thanks for watching. See you next time.